Okay, I'll be reading four poems about four cities. The first one is about Lake Como, where they have all these celebrity weddings. And the second one will be from the city of my birth, Bombay. The third one will be for Hyderabad, where I live now, which is my city as much as anybody else's. And the fourth will be a translation of Faiz Ahmad Faiz, returned from Dhaka after the Bangladesh war. Now this long poem is my most ambitious poem. It may be a failed poem, but then, you know, one should have ambition even if one fails. It's a long poem and you will have to pay close attention to it. And it's about the scenery behind the Mona Lisa. The scenery, if you think of it, the mountains and the rivers, that river is called the Milk Grotto. And of course, the Mona Lisa is she is, of course, an enchantress, but she's also a mother figure, no? The Milk Grotto, the milk of the mother, and so on. So I take this thing, I talk about my parents, I link it with the Kashmir of my favorite poet, Aga Shahid Ali, and I end with a kind of saying sorry to my father because I haven't forgiven him yet. And of course, I talk about at the end about the art of poetry. I talk about the poem, you know, like a modernist poet should go back to the poem. It is self-referential. It's called, the title of course is Echo of Aga Shahid Ali. I dream I'm on the last lake of the world. Midnight, Durga Puja, the day of the Great Mother, and I dream I'm on the last lake of the world. Two worlds, two lakes, joined by a river, Lake Maggiore and Lake Minore, joined by the Styx, a lake of light, joined to the dark lake by the river of forgetfulness, and on the river of memory, a light glints like a diamond in my mother's ear, or a crystal in a chandelier. Mother appears in a flash from the lake mirror and is gone, Our Lady of the Waters, and she's always born on song, Mirabai or Begum Akhtar. It is a seasonal, cyclic love, Demeter's for her daughter, Persephone, the earth mother keening her spring daughter to birth, and now I am my mother's mother, birthing her in memory and song, the flood of song on a lake, on two lakes joined like two lungs or air chambers or communicating vases by the narrowest of corridors, a hair-thin bridge which for the righteous becomes long and broad, a highway into eternity, and on this highway comes thundering my lover like Rossi on his prize bike in a velodrome, dead of a fall at 27. Thrown by his mount, they say he writhed on the highway 20 minutes like an insect before death stilled him. As flies to wanton boys, so are we to the gods. They kill us for their sport. Those whom the gods love die young, so that for all the inherent evil in a young life passes away, and there is no time for quarrels, for the settling of scores, the squaring of a lifetime's accounts, and eternity itself is stilled, cheated of its terrors. I underestimated the love of an Oriental despot for his harem. I thought to be Sherazade, to cheat death with a fistful of rhymes. I thought to mother him, who was born to mind only mistresses. So how do you find your son, Mistress Death? Rossi's bike, his chariot of death, gifted him for his impending marriage by his own mother, and Sharon awaits to row me up the Styx from the lake of light, the lake of shadows. Or are we from shadows going into eternal light? It is a boatman on the Ganga taking a wailing woman to another ghat, her own having gone up in flames, or was it drowned in too much water? I was to be a bodhisattva crossing life's flood on a reed. Kaise jaun Jamuna ke teer? How will I get to the Jamuna's other shore? Cries the lovelorn Radha, pining for her Krishna song. which he plays from a distant shore. She hears, but cannot be near. And I hear again in my mind's ear a childhood memory my mother sang, which I cannot ever hear her sing again. Is it why I hear it with a stab of pain on the radio? And the boatman waiting to ferry me when I was young was then young himself. And now I'm like an old man, and I traverse Lake Como to the Count's house to visit his grave, my brother in life and death. Why did Leonardo place his Mona Lisa before Lake Como? Because he wished his siren to hear the gushing cataract, the milk stream or the Milky Way sing the siren song of death. Is this why we feel a stab of pain before the Mona Lisa as we do before a mirror? Our mother comes to greet us out of the placid lake-like glass. She has our eyes, our mouth, our smile. She laughs and is gone in a twinkle of an eye. And the blood in our veins, her veins really, gushes, flushes better after red wine, Vino Rossi. We feel ourselves to be flagons through which shines a light like the mild spring sun through the translucent poppy in the field where Mussolini was trussed up to die. And the motorcycle thunders down the highway screaming, whore, it is my lover calling me the name, the whore Mother Mary, whore of Babylon, whoring Rome. But Rome is never finished, and our lovers always go away. So who is the prostitute, the substitute, and who whore master man? The highway to Rome is really the Styx, and the motor car is really a barge, and the boatman is a devil pushing Michelangelo off the boat, as in his Last Judgment, because he has whored the mother as the Pietà, a young lover of a young son, and the marble is translucent. Through her face shines the light that I see in my sister's soaring face or in my mother's in the mirror. And a long line of penitent sons go to Rome, long cloaked, barefoot, bareheaded. They have given up the father's whoring marketplace for the cloisters of the Divine Mother. They till God's little acre for 7 centuries as an answer to the banks, and the banks that still thirst blood, because it is only young son's blood that turns gold. Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. I dream I'm on the glass cart of the world, where demon son Ravana is being burnt, popping like crackers, Bali bombed as if by revelers' fireworks, and the parrot bought a beak full of water to douse the flames, knowing his wing will be singed. Mother Durga spears her favorite demon. We see her feet reflected in a water trough. She's ready to flow to sea as a river, to return next year as rain, as grain. The last boat is about to leave, and my Anglo-Indian teacher comes hat in hand, a gaunt Whitman against the grain, saying, Ho Shang, you haven't yet written your long poem. And the lovers always go away. This is about Bombay. Bombay, city of my birth, gateway to India, gateway to my mother's home, my home by the sea, my father's many homes by many seas, light of a chandelier, mirror light, sea light, verandas and verandas lit by strife, my parents, city of my father's survival, but not of mine. Bombay is the arch of the Parsi Library at Fort. It is the Queen statue now demolished for a skyscraper, a God scraper. It is the vista of banyan trees and crow shit. George V riding a black steed into oblivion. The bed I groaned on 3 days, an adolescent effort to do away with myself. The Persian rug brought from an English man, to which I brought Persian boys. My city of sunsets, though never of sunrise, my city of sleeplessness, its pavements pockmarked against spills and slips, the city of horse-drawn hansoms and men-drawn carts, the city of pavements but of closed doors and ways, city to the end of night, city of vistas and strange, strains to strange interiors, islands of birds and salt and fisherwomen who sell their bodies. Babu Log sell their minds. City of water and cement, city of dust and cars, city of black money and gold and hunger. City, city where magnolia grew, city chasing suburbs, suburbs chasing men, chasing dream fun and girls from films, city of celluloid dreams, city where I was born blind, which teaches nothing and forgives nothing. City of pigeons fed by the pious at the GPO and the pier. City of teachers who are clerks, clerks who are bosses, doormen who are kings. City of Art Nouveau elevators and staircases to nothing. City where my great-grandfather made and lost two fortunes in the stock market of stars and ill-fated horoscopes. City of my father's two wives. City of chimneys where cotton was king and opium the dessert for day-long sweating. City where Taj Mahal is a hotel and Shangri-La a brothel. City, how I escaped you these many years to Hollywood, Jerusalem, Paris, Sodom, and found your chief's trumpet tree for all everywhere. City, now I'm tears, an instant poem, and a pillar of salt.
The first poem that I'm reading is the introductory poem to my collection. It's called Medusa in a Burqa. You're all familiar with Medusa, the Greek character who had serpents on her hair, and she was, you know, posted on those shields because she could turn people into stones. So Medusa in a burqa, I run with the hem of my burqa held between my teeth as your bomb-sniffing dogs bark at me. I sail on wind sandals across the sky, munching neoliberalism from chips packets. Helicopters fan civilization on my head. You stamp my profile on smart guns, but dare not look me into the eyes, for I will turn you into a stone. I am the millennial Medusa, serpents under my burqa. That's it. The second poem is about Yusuf, as related in Quran, and Joseph in Bible, you might be familiar with. So this is about Zuleika, who falls in love with this man who is much younger to her, and he is the slave. And after a separation and a lot of penance, she gets Gabriel, the archangel, comes with the news that she can be reunited with Yusuf. But for that, she will have to become young again. Her youth has to be restored. But in the bargain, because this bonanza is given only once, in the afterlife, she will be old. So in many renderings of the story, Zuleika does actually agree to this, but in this retelling she totally rejects it. And the poem goes like this. Zuleika reads Freud to Yusuf, so there's this deliberate anachronism. Zuleika's youth shall be restored, Angel Gabriel says, fluttering into the court of Yusuf. It has been ordained she shall marry Yusuf, but she alone shall be old in the hereafter, where everyone will be young. I reject the bargain, Zuleika says, combing her unruly hair, holding the moon for a mirror. It's a pity, she says, sexless angels don't know how a woman falls in love. Love that rules every void in the heavens, the revolving celestial spheres, are but I, mad Zuleika, yearning for my Yusuf. Oh, Yusuf, for your sake alone, my darling, I disgraced myself in front of my pagan gods. Remember Echo, woman of a few words, who fell in love with Narcissus? But then, the not-so-beautiful nymphs, were they turned into trees? I clutched your ropes like a ship in a storm. I fought drought, hunger, poverty, gave all away, my jewels, my royal robes, and my sight to the roguish boys who teased me with the false rumors of your arrival. Remember the fateful dream, 7 lean cows, 7 plus 7 years of loneliness? I wear age like an ornament. My wrinkled face is the only testament of my love for you. Zuleika holds up the interpretation of dreams, flings it at the king of dreams. She pauses, disclaims. Tell me, Yusuf, can a man interpret a woman's dreams? Can a he parse a she dream? Can a masculine phantom, the feminine divine? Can't. Clouds discover the moon. The mirror is a fog. Gabriel cannot tell Yusuf from Zuleika, who is turning turns, play acting, schizophrenia. Gabriel suspects. Zuleika stares endlessly at Yusuf seated on the throne, her long hair reflecting the light of the 11 dead stars. Thank you. And the last one is a gift for my daughter, not yet conceived. I gift you millennia of confusion in my genes, muffled chromosomes and a double X to excavate epiphanies. I sow doubt in my womb, watered with fears. I gift you my unsettled struggles, uncommitted sins, unnoticed virtues, unread and half-read books, 3x2-inch laminated paper in the name of identity, a ragged map to be carved from the cracks between divorced nations. I gift you unyielding obsessions, unexplored passions, a horoscope of cusps, and finally, Hamlet's unfinished line to the valley, to be or not to be, that is. Do we have time for another poem or so? Okay. Okay. So I can maybe read one more. It's called The Lightness of Being in a Heavily Militarized Zone. Before they lay barbed wires across our tongues, let's sing of almond blossoms. Before they harvest our thoughts, let's think what we want to think. Before they wall our sleep, let's whisper our dreams into our ears. Before they blind us with a burst of lead, let's mirror our darkness. Let's engrave the story on the palm of our hands before they erase our words. Thank you very much. Thank you.
सबसे पहले मैं एक शेर सुनाऊंगी, जिसके बाद में मैं तीन नज़में सुनाऊंगी। ताकत मेरे ख़लम की तो कुछ इतनी बढ़ गई, ताकत मेरे ख़लम की तो कुछ इतनी बढ़ गई, लोगों ने इसको जंग का सामा बता दिया। ये जो नज़म है ये हमारे क्लाउड्स पे है, जो मोबाइल में भी है और ऊपर भी है। बादलों से पूछो तुम ज़िंदगी में क्या क्या है, बादलों से पूछो तुम ज़िंदगी में क्या क्या है, अपना क्यों पराया है और पराया अपना है, अपना क्यों पराया है और पराया अपना है, फेसबुक पर किसने कल दिल की बात लिखी थी, फेसबुक पर किसने कल दिल की बात लिखी थी, कौन ट्वीट करता है, नफ़रतें फैलाता है, कानून खोखला क्यों है, कानून खोखला क्यों है, कौन वरगलाता है, काश हम समझ पाते बादलों में क्या क्या है, लड़कियों पे जुल्म आज जगह जगह होता है, और व्हाट्सएप पर वो दुनिया भर में घूमता है, देखते तो सब ही हैं और कुछ नहीं करते, देखते तो सब ही हैं और कुछ नहीं करते, कितने होंठ बोलते हैं क्यों जुबान पे ताला है, बादलों में दुनिया भर दस्तावेज़ घूमते हैं, दस्तावेज़ डॉक्यूमेंट्स, बादलों में दुनिया भर दस्तावेज़ घूमते हैं, गली गली वीडियो भी बादलों में चलते हैं, सड़कें लंबी लंबी हैं और दिलों में तंगी है, सड़कें लंबी लंबी हैं और दिलों में तंगी है, काश हम समझ पाते बादलों में क्या क्या है। ये नज़म में हमारे पुराने शहर की जो लड़कियों को शेख मैरिजेस किया जाता है, द गर्ल्स आर मैरिड ऑफ टू द ओल्ड अरब्स, तो एक लड़की की आवाज़ है ये। माँ को तकलीफ़ ना हो खर्च का कोई बोझ ना हो, माँ को तकलीफ़ ना हो खर्च का कोई बोझ ना हो, मेरे भाइयों के लिए एक नया तारा चमके, मेरे जाने से मेरे घर में उजाला आए, घर में चूल्हा तो जलेगा नए कपड़े होंगे, घर में चूल्हा तो जलेगा नए कपड़े होंगे, दिल ने सोचा चलो सौदा कर ले, मैं थी 16 की वो था 65 का, मैं थी 16 की वो था 65 का ईंट पर ईंट रखे एक नया छत बन जाए रात ही रात मेरा घर महल बन जाए नया टीवी नया नई गाड़ी नया मोबाइल मिले दिल ने सोचा चलो सौदा कर ले रात आई थी बहुत रातों के बाद आई थी रात आई थी लम्स की सौगात लिए ख्वाहिशों की नई बारात लिए एक तूफान सा उठा था दिल में नई चाहत बनकर पास आया ही था वो कि जोश जुनू ठंडा हुआ पास आया ही था वो कि जोश जुनू ठंडा हुआ रात भर सुंद पड़ी तकिया मेरा रोता रहा आँख जो मूंद ली बिस्तर दोज होने लगी देखती क्या हूँ मेरे बाजू मेरे हाथ बने रेत का ढेर मेरी रग रग में सीमेंट फैल गई दीवारें खड़ी होने लगीं एक नया महल बना नगर बना शहर बना मेरा मासूम बदन इसी महल तले नगर तले शहर तले दफन हुआ ये हमारी श्रीदेवी जी के लिए है श्रीदेवी जो 54 साल की थी और जिसका के इंतकाल पे हम सब काफ़ी टीवी पे उसको देखते रहे ऊंची सैंडल पहन के निकली चलती फिरती गुड़िया हूँ मैं नीरो मोदी लाए मोती नीरो मोदी चुराए मोती लाल गौहर मेरे जेवर रेशम किमखाब बदन को ढांके मेरी झूठी पलकें काली मेरी झूठी पलकें काली होठों पर मुस्कान लिए गाल प्लास्टिक होंठ प्लास्टिक नथनियां मेरी हैं कॉस्मेटिक आलीशान महलों में फिरती हूँ कौन जाने किधर मैं निकली मुझ पर सबकी नज़र टिकी रूह की कांच अटक गई है सैंडल मेरी टूट गई है वजूद मेरा तितर बितर लाल शरबत हलक में अटका रंग रंग में तूफा उमड़ा अंग अंग में तूफा उमड़ा बूंद बूंद उम्मीद है जागी चलती फिरती 54 साला मैं गुड़िया हूँ चलती फिरती 54 साला मैं गुड़िया हूँ वक्त ने छीनी लम्स की बोली बदन की किश्ती डोल डोल मैं निकल पड़ी वजूद से अपने परे मैं निकली टुकड़े टुकड़े रूह के बिखरे मेरा हर टुकड़ा मंशूर बना मेरा हर टुकड़ा मंशूर बना हर गुड़िया का एक प्लास्टिक चेहरा मेरी चिता को दे घूर रहा था हर गुड़िया का एक प्लास्टिक चेहरा मेरे बदन को घूर रहा था मेरी चिता को घूर रहा था लेकिन मैं तो इस दुनिया से उस पाताल से दोनों जहां से आगे निकली दोनों जहां से आगे निकली अगर टाइम है ओके तो एक चार शेर सुना दूंगी मैं आपको जो थोड़ा मुश्किल तो हैं नहीं एक और नज़म जो आसिफा के बारे में सभी जानते हैं जो कश्मीर का है हर दिन की तरह मैं हरनी बनी दौड़ चली घोड़ों को घास खिलाऊंगी वादी वादी नाचूंगी रूह को मेरे पंख लगे मैं दौड़ चली ना सोचा कुछ ना समझा कुछ किस्मत में क्या क्या लिखा था अंकल दबे पाँव आया पीछे से मुझको जकड़ लिया वादी और पहाड़ी सब गोल गोल क्यों घूम गए खह खह गूंजे खम्बे नाचे पलकों में सूरज डूबा भगवान भी जैसे घूर रहा था रानों से लाल पानी बहा हड्डी से चिमटा गोश्त का टुकड़ा पूछ रहा था आखिर ये सब क्या हुआ रूह के पंख पट 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 टूट पड़े न जान में पाई न समझ में पाई लाल समंदर में जैसे मेरा वजूद गलता हुआ सब माया है। दो मिनट। सब माया है, माता ने कहा, बदन की कश्ती टूटी फूटी कशकोल बनी तैर रही थी, चारों तरफ किश्ती पे सवार, मैं खुद से परे, दोनों जहाँ से दूर अदम की ओर चल पड़ी, मेरा कमसिन नाजुक बदन सीढ़ियों पर पड़ा रहा, परमात्मा को सब है पता, आत्मा मेरी चीख रही है, क्या ये सब कुछ माया है, क्या नन्ना बदन जंग का मैदान, कैसी जंग ये जारी है।
थैंक यू।
सिंस द टाइम्स ऑफ जेफरी चासर एंड सिंस द टाइम्स ऑफ मेनी पोएट्स इन डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस, नेचर पोएट्री हैज बिकम वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट पेंचेंट फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वन विच अल्यूड ऑल द पोएट्स। सो नेचर पोएट्री, सो ऑल द टाइम प्रेजिंग एंड द विश टू बी इन द लैप ऑफ द नेचर सेंस द एस्पेशियली फ्रॉम द रूसो टाइम्स ऑफ नेचुरलिज्म एंड ऑल द थिंग अदर थिंग्स दैट हैज बीकम वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ एनी पोएट टू एक्सप्रेस हिज ओन आइडियाज दैट वॉज देयर। बट नव डेज वॉट आई थॉट ऑफ माई सेल्फ इज दैट इट इज नीड ऑफ द अवर, दोज वर द डेज गॉन बाई एज फार एज नेचर पोएट्री इज कंसर्न, बट नाउ इट इज नीड ऑफ द अवर टू शिफ्ट अवर अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स इको पोएट्री। So these are the times which necessitates of the important concept, because we are the poets are the torchbearers of the society. So it is need of the hour to pose and shift our attention towards eco poetry, to make the people to sensitize towards ecological things that are being happening and the devastating activities that are being done by the human beings with one or the other things. So as a tribute to eco poetry, I wrote one of the poems. Just I would like to recite it in Telugu first, and then I will read the English version too. The title of the poem is Akupatsani Poddu Podupu. Anadi yugala nundi patsani chira neelam deham errani mukham ee nela talli singaram ame mettati kongu chaatune edigi edigi కోతి కొమ్మల ఆటలాడి అల్లనేరేడు పండ్లు తిని పెరిగి పెరిగి పెద్దగై మనం విస్తరించి జనం విజృంభించి అమ్మ చీరనే పీలికలు చీలికలు చేసినాం. దశాబ్దాల క్రితమే పడమర దిక్కున ఎగిసిన యంత్రభూతం ఆకాశాన్ని తూట్లు పొడిచి భూగోళాన్ని అగ్నిమండలం చేసింది. అన్ని కాలాలు శిశిరాలుగా మారాక మాంట్రియల్ రియో క్యోటోలలో గొంతు దాటిన ఆర్తనాదం విశ్వమంతా ఎగిసింది. ఆకులే పడుగు పేకలుగా పచ్చని చీర మళ్ళీ నేయాలనే సంకల్పం మొదలైంది. ఎడారులన్నీ చెట్ల బిడారులుగా బీళ్ళన్నీ పూల బగీచాలుగా మార్చే పచ్చ పచ్చని స్వప్నం బీజంగా మొలిచింది. మొన్న ఒక్క మనిషి దీక్ష కోట్ల ప్రజల కలని నిజం చేసింది. గియాల ఒక్క పిడుగడు మట్టి కోట్ల మొక్కలకు ప్రాణం పోసింది. జన తెలంగాణ ఇప్పుడు పట్టుబట్టి జట్టు కట్టి వన తెలంగాణమై కొత్త రంగులు దిద్దుకుంది. గుండు రాంపల్లి చెట్టు రాంపల్లిగా రూపాంతరించాక హర్షంతో ఆకాశం వర్షపు అక్షింతలు చల్లాక చెట్టు పాట పాడింది. కొమ్మల కోలాటం ఆకుల ధూమ్ధామ్ పువ్వుల యక్షగానం పండ్ల జానపదం తోడై గాలి డోలు కట్టింది మబ్బు దరువేసింది. చిన్నారి చేతులు మట్టికి జీవం పోసినై ముడుతల చేతికర్రలకు కొత్త చిగుళ్ళేసినై. ఇప్పుడు తెల్లంగా తెల్లారింది తెలంగాణ జగమంతా ముచ్చటగా మురిసింది. ఆకుపచ్చని చందమామ చూపిన బంగారు తొవ్వ ఇది హరితహారం పుట్టించే రేపటి బువ్వకు పునాది ఇది. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద తెలుగు వర్షన్ అండ్ నౌ ఐ రీడ్ ది ఇంగ్లీష్ వర్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. గ్రీన్ డాన్ ఫ్రమ్ ఏన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏన్స్ అన్కౌంటబుల్ పాస్టరల్ శారీ బ్లూయిష్ బాడీ రెడ్డిష్ ఫేస్ ఆర్ ఆర్నమెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ మదర్ ఎర్త్స్ అడార్నమెంట్. We grew in the shade of her soft sari hem, played games, ate jamuns, exulted, rioted. The same sari hem we tore into shreds. Decades ago, the machine sprite had soared on west, perforated the sky, and turned the globe to a blazing world. After every season had become an autumn. After every season had become an autumn. Distress cries rose in Montreal, Rio, Kyoto. A resolve to weave a green saree with leaves as warp and weft commenced. A green dream to convert deserts into oases. Arid lands to bloom gardens unfolded itself. A single man's grit realized. The dream of millions now. Today, a fistful of mud gave birth to crores of plants. Telangana folks are now a resolute team. Due to them, ours is now a garden state. Telangana folks are now a resolute team. Due to them, ours is now a garden state. After rocky Rampalli turned to garden Rampalli, when firmament sprinkled fine raindrops with glee, trees have sung green songs. Trees have sung green songs. Kolatam of tree branches, fanfare of green leaves, Yakshaganam of flowers, folk songs of fruits, all have mingled in one another. Wind beat dolu and clouds sounded drums. Tiny hands of babies doled out life to mud. Tiny hands of babies doled out life to mud. Walking sticks of wrinkled hands got sprouted. Now, dawn made the world fully white. Telangana became totally a cheer land now. This is the path shown by the gorgeous green moon. A foundation it is to the food grains of future. Thank you very much.
So the first poem is from a series that I wrote last year while I was spending some time with the salt workers in Gujarat. This series has four poems. The first one is called Namak. The others are Haldi, Mirchi and Mahua. If I have the time, I'll read the last one also. The first one, Namak. Spices of the great Indian desert. One, Namak. This is addressed to a figure called Sebastianos, who is a kind of comrade figure. Namak. Sebastianos, on this cracked earth, your words follow me like sheer salt, endless, involved, and burning white. The run runs into me, thirsting, and yet shimmering wild from giving away its secrets. I'm riven within and rendered speechless. This faculty for silence helps me know the ones who rake the soul of salt, urges me to surrender to the true peers of death in the wilderness. As they cook salt under the sun and witness the moon brew remembrances in their pans, their feet turn into satyagrahis, surpassing fire. Sebastianos, your voice agonizes over rarities such as love and prayer. In our agitated times, I wish you the patience of a master of cuisines. Our seeking must learn the art of survival from salt, this aboriginal theater of war. It lends us this basis profounder than time and sets our movements free. Let us listen to this perky young salt maker relate the fire-like way of salt, his inheritance of water latent in the vivid imagination of this thirsty land. Salting to taste seems the sole way to season our clay, give it the flavor of faith. Knowing its measure may help us play out the capricious game of remaking love. The second poem is the title poem of my first book. It's for Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi has always been an intriguing figure for all of us. I have always thought that there is a possibility of convergence in Gandhi. As Hoshang said, sometimes it's a failed attempt, but like even if it's failed, your ambition should not be stopped. So it's called Yonak. One, it was astonishing, Mahatma. the way you brought home our prehistory. When you came into our fretful midst with your gospel of survival, singing hermaphroditic nonviolence and resisting aggression with womanly force. Before you too, we had lived our epics, but by seeking an eye for an eye and stone for stone. The idols had been our last weapons during violent times. We had been warriors heedless of enmity till your motherly prayers tempered our times. Bare visionary, you reminded us of our lost art of bonding without merging. Never doubting the meaning of borders, our princes in exile had donned the double guise. In our palaces, man had turned woman, and in our forests, woman into man. We knew how the transvestite covered one best against indomitable warriors, and our eunuchs were fertile, elegantly poised on pillars between the human and the divine. Thus, your spinning joined all, memory and dream, man and woman, journey and destination, effeminate dictator. Now we see you were our last Arthanarishwara. Our symbols had cunningly called you father. Mahatma, pardon those who steal your body to freeze you in manhood. After you, the eunuch has remained in fragments, implanted breast, uneven voice, evening stubble over above a sari of autumnal gold, a revealing act. Now we are a castrated age, neither here nor there, powerless either to bless or to curse, yet clapping aloud in the streets. Last one is a long poem, but I'll only read a short portion of it. It is dedicated to Mukhtar Mai, who was gang raped allegedly by a village council, gang raped and on the orders of a village council, because her brother was seen with a powerful, a woman from a powerful tribe. So I'll just read the last portion. It's called Parda for Mukhtar Mai. Mukhtar Mai, chosen lamb of Mirwala, cinder from the fiery game of good and evil. Everyone knew you did not deserve your fate. Your brother Shakur was too young to outrage a Mastoi woman's modesty. Perhaps they thought you would wear the parda of fear and flee to the collective Siddhas in the dark womb of earth. You turned into fire again, brought our sun back. But the windless sky and the rainless earth tell me that enormous heaps of charcoal and ash are formed in the furnaces of honor before every dawn. While still looking at your sunrise, I know elsewhere another woman's body has become a nameless messenger running among nations, tribes and men. Sons, lift our veil of myth. Thank you.
It's a song in Gujarati. Vedana tu andhana kar, Vedana tu netra de. Vedana tu andhana kar, Vedana tu netra de. Kodiya dhari lidha batris kothe, le have avatu salgavatu jalhal banavi de mane. અગન પંપાળી શકે એવો પ્રસન્ન કરાગ્ર દે, વેદના તું અંધ ના કર, વેદના તું નેત્ર દે. ધેર ઇઝ અ પોએમ વિચ આઈ રોટ ઓન બામિયાન બુદ્ધ. સી, ધેર ઇઝ અ ફોર્મ્યુલા ટુ ટેક અપ અ મેજર ઇવેન્ટ ઇન યોર કલ્ચર એન્ડ રાઇટ અબાઉટ ઇટ. સમટાઈમ્સ વી ફીલ દેટ ઇફ ધ મેજર ઇવેન્ટ ઇઝ મેજર ઇનફ, the poem also will become major. Now this is a mistake. That is why so much bad poetry is written in India today. You could either act, go there and do some action, or you can be a journalist and report it properly, or if you could write a poem do not write as a journalist or as an activist. Write as a poet. So here is a poem on Buddha, Bamiyan Buddha, whom you know in Afghanistan, he was, the idol was destroyed. Had it not been a statue in stone, had he been standing there in the Bamiyan cave, Tathagata himself, he would have stood as still. Eyes like lotus, peace on the face, his thin garment fluttering in the hot winds, a smile on the lips, hand raised only to bless the faceless man, the fearless man. I'm sorry, the last line was the fearless man. As we heard some excellent poems on the salt workers in Gujarat, which transformed the material into a poem, and not just reported how the salt workers were badly treated or how they had to suffer and so on, nothing of the sort. It was an image of pain and suffering which the poet presented before us. I have a poem on Vishwamitri. You probably know that there is a river called Vishwamitri near my hometown, Vadodara. It's a small little river, and we have turned it into a gutter, as we have done with so many rivers. But this is a smaller one, easier to insult. So, and the word Vishwamitra, it comes from Vishwamitra, is a sage. Vishwamitra's daughter is Vishwamitri. Now, Vishwamitra means friend of the whole world. Sare Vishwa ka mitra. Abhi aap socho, is jamane mein Vishwamitra hona kya sambhav hai? To itna saral nahi bana sakte hai ki hum Vishwa ke mitra ban gaye hai. Hum bhi delude ho jayenge, Vishwa to aisa hi rahega. So, that's why this Vishwamitri behind the bend. He dashed forth to offer friendship to all, a sage whom they called Vishwamitra. He didn't know much of a world busy with mutual maneuvers. It lost no time to dump upon him dirty heaps of disrespect. She is a listless daughter of some such sage, our river, Vishwamitri. She has no intimate wash places where women might come to bathe, no public wharves where sailing ships could pause for a refill, no quiet sidewalks near her flow for an evening stroll. Pandits standing in waist deep, uttering shlokas to Surya, or padres baptizing others in the name of the sun. She has none. No water at all, in fact, that could rightly be called water. She flows on, mute, dragging along some nameless fluid, finds a narrow passage between the beasts locked up for life in a big zoo, there is a zoo nearby, and the citizens of my town loitering lost for a while in the big garden. Like a leper woman, she retreats with her limbs drawn into herself. This river of ours cannot afford to have shame, hope, pain, or a faint smile on her lips. Whenever I have looked at her straight, she has each time lowered her gaze and slid away behind that bend over there. Though, if you thought of it, she too might have been once a river, just as Ganga, Seine, Volga, Nile, Thames, Huang Ho, Mississippi, Amazon, all are rivers, she too was perhaps one, much smaller, yet a river, water cruising along, in which water creatures lived. A full moon was reflected, stags with tangled horns at dawn, and at late evenings, cheetahs with glistening bodies bent their heads in respect and then took a drink, on whose two banks farmlands, made thirsty by strong summer sun, suckled, crouching in a row, their lips tremblings like lovely infants. Whenever I say such things, standing on that bridge over there, stretched across her, softly, so that only she might hear, she has each time pretended not to hear me. She would close her eyes shut, pull sari around her thin body, draw a cover of floating dirt across her face, go away in some haste behind that bend. Rarely, though, at last, when things got beyond her endurance, then on a monsoon night in the dark, she is in spate, this river, she overflows every eye, she overflows like the eyes of a blind girl. Early, pre-dawn, next, she climbs over the banks quite quickly, rushes to the town square, lifts herself up on the tips of her feet, rising up to the feet of her king, once so caring, now dressed in black clothes, seated on a black horse. Turned to stone, seeing him like this, she stops, stares, understands, bites her tongue, shuts her lips up, dries her tears with the back of her hand, and all by herself falls back, recedes, noiseless, stepping through all the mud, goes away behind that bend.
So I'll basically read love poems, two from my previous collection, one new one, and a tribute. Synesthetic. Passport photographs are libelous. I demand that you send, when you are asked for a likeness, a picture of your voice instead. Go into a recording studio and wait for a light to go green before you speak your name clearly into a microphone. They will print for you a waveform image of your voice. In its lines, asymmetrical but steady, I will detect the timbre of your voice and know you by these lines that rise and fall, abstract as thumb impressions or spectrographs, all shape and pattern, darkness and light. One day, because we need to make portraits of our voices if we want our pictures to speak to us, you and I might find ourselves in that studio having our voice impressions taken. And because no one else need identify us by these pictures, you will speak my name and I yours. And we will lay these photographs where our voices are intent and serious, one beside the other, and marvel at how beautiful our names look when spoken by another. Not loss, but residue. He writes me letters at the back of the bus, a sacred text on a grain of rice, things he does not say to me over the phone. Old-fashioned, I call him and laugh at the things he says. When he speaks, he stammers. Ink stains the page. What I have is a sword he has given me willingly. Just for once, I want all the power to keep you waiting on my words measure my satisfaction in your loss, just for once. I'm sitting at the window reading. My eyes slide down the page and everything changes. You reach your hand past my breast and grab my heart. Squeeze. It smells of rust and weeds at low tide, your hand a slow-mo pulse. I discover that there are no such things as heartstrings. When you tell me you dream of falling, I find ways to remove everything that could break your fall. It is not your fall I want to break. Just for once, I want to talk to you and give nothing away. He dreams my hands are cut off at the wrist and wakes up crying. I flex my fingers, make a fist, take his hand and hold them as a lover might. His wrists have lines that might be scars. I place my hand against his, palm to palm, as children and dancers do. The measure of love is not loss, but residue, vasana. Leave if you must, but leave me a groove in the mind down which memory can run like a cultivated habit. How am I doing for time? Lots. Okay. A montage on lovers. When he leaves, she is condensed by shock until, like a seed, she becomes the original of herself. For her, it was hard to be in love again. It put her under serious pleasure. He was irresistible as only the very young of any species are programmed to be. He played enthusiasm like a sport. No, he did not play. He imagined. The two things are different only because of outcomes. Somewhere outside this paradise, which is after all nothing but an enclosed garden, are places where outcomes are not surrounded by walls. She wonders what to call the things that are placed in paradise. She considers inoculating herself against future shock by administering small daily doses of loss. Against her better judgment, she finds she has become a hoarder. He also was a hoarder, but a stealthier one. What he hoarded and where he stored it are enduring secrets. It was always difficult to say they. It's a word that did not come easily to either of their tongues. But that is not why she left, why he left. That was an act of superb, of beautiful disentanglement. She condenses, he deliquesces. Incoherence and silence are not the same thing. Hoarding and holding are not the same thing. One final poem, which is a tribute to the poet Eunice D'Souza, whose collection of poems, Women in Dutch Painting, was probably the first poem that I owned all by myself as a collection, and that I read out for pleasure, not because it was a set text. Testament for Eunice D'Souza. From you I learnt to winnow words, give them room to breathe, silence in which to grow grass wild. A single flower at a difficult summer's end will bloom fiercely and for a long time. Thank you.
Attempt fusion of poetry and dance. Just the track two.
ये जाते हुए बादल मेरा पैगाम लेकर जाएंगे, ये जाते हुए बादल मेरा पैगाम लेकर जाएंगे, हवाओं में तेरी खुशबू होगी, हर अंग कली का खिल जाएगा, हर अंग कली का खिल जाएगा, इन फूलों पर तेरी जवानी होगी, इन फूलों पर तेरी जवानी होगी। ये दूर कहीं दर्द खड़े, दर्द ट्रीज को कहते हैं, ये दूर कहीं दर्द खड़े ये खामोश चट्टाने, चिड़ियों की है चहचहाहट खामोश वीराने, ये दूर कहीं दर्द खड़े ये खामोश चट्टाने, चिड़ियों की है चहचहाहट खामोश वीराने। सावन का खुला आंचल आंचल में फंसाने, सावन का खुला आंचल आंचल में फंसाने, वो दूर निगाहों से बरसते तराने, सावन का खुला आंचल आंचल में फंसाने, वो दूर निगाहों से बरसते तराने, मिट्टी की महक ऐसी अंग अंग में समा जाए, मिट्टी की महक ऐसी अंग अंग में समा जाए, भूले से नहीं भूले वो तेरे जमाने, भूले से नहीं भूले वो तेरे जमाने, पलकों में छुपी आग को फिर से जलाने, जो ख्वाब चले गए थे, पलकों में छुपी आग को फिर से जलाने, आंखों में तेरे देखूं ख्वाबों के बहाने, पलकों में छुपी आग को फिर से जलाने, आंखों में तेरे देखूं ख्वाबों के बहाने, सांसों में तेरी गुजरूं जीने के बहाने, सांसों में तेरी गुजरूं जीने के बहाने, कैसे मैं ये भूलूं वो होंठ सुहाने, कैसे मैं ये भूलूं वो होंठ सुहाने। मैं बैठा गुमसुम ये सोच रहा हूं, शायद बैठा नहीं खड़ा, मैं बैठा गुमसुम ये सोच रहा हूं कि एक तेरे न होने से क्या होता है, मैं यहां फूल रंग घटा खुशबू चांद और तारे, मैं यहां फूल रंग घटा खुशबू चांद और तारे, इन सब को मिलाए तेरी एक तस्वीर बनाए बैठा हूं और तुझसे बातें करता हूं, जाने क्यों लोग मुझे शायर कहते हैं, जाने क्यों लोग मुझे शायर कहते हैं, ये जाते हुए बादल मेरा पैगाम लेकर जाएंगे, हवाओं में तेरी खुशबू होगी, हर अंग कली का खिल जाएगा, इन फूलों पर तेरी जवानी होगी। थैंक यू मंगला जी। हम दूसरी नज्म की ओर चलते हैं, वाई देर इज सो मच ऑफ रिबा, दूसरी नज्म की ओर चलते हैं जिसका टाइटल है औरत। ये मेरा मानना है कि अगर इस कायनात से
अगर आप औरतों को निकाल दें तो इस कायनात में कुछ भी नहीं बचेगा। मुझे एक औरत का हुस्न तो दिखता है, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ उसकी हिम्मत और उसकी ताकत भी नज़र आती है। तो ये मेरा ट्रिब्यूट है तमाम औरतों के लिए, सारी दुनिया के, टाइटल औरत। मैं वक्त हूँ और इस गूंज की आवाज हूँ, मेरे सफ़ों पर तेरा वजूद जाहिर हुआ और इसी दामन पर तेरे अनेक रूप जलवानुमा थे। तू इस कायनात की सबसे पुरअसर, दिलखुश, रंगीन और दिलचस्प इजाद है। तू औरत है, तू कहीं नूर है तो कहीं जलवा, कहीं ख्वाब है तो कहीं ताबीर, कहीं इंतहा तो कहीं जुस्तजू, कहीं हासिल तो कहीं आरजू, कहीं संगदिल तो कहीं नजाकत, कहीं ख्याल तो कहीं हकीकत। कभी हर्फ बनकर सवाल बन जाती हो, कभी कहानी की तरह किताबों में ढल जाती हो। नाजुक अगर है तो गुलाब की तरह, इरादे अगर मजबूत हों तो चट्टान की तरह। गंगा से उभरती है अगर पाकीजगी तेरी, तो जमुना में बहता है अक्स तेरा। फैले हैं तेरे दामन में रिश्ते कई इस वक्त के, गुजरे हैं कई जमाने तेरी आंचल की पनाह में। तेरे रंग नूर का जादू उभरता है हर दिन के उजाले से, गुजरती है तेरी सांसों में मेरी जिंदगी ऐसे, जैसे बाद सबा को मिल गई हो मंजिल को ही। हम कुछ भी कहें भी तो कह नहीं पाएंगे, कहने से कभी दास्तानें पूरी नहीं होती। मैं वक्त होकर भी तेरे अनगिनत रूप को बयान नहीं कर सकता, लेकिन इतना जरूर कहूंगा कि तेरी सबसे बड़ी ताकत तू खुद है। तेरा खुद पे भरोसा तेरी सबसे बड़ी ताकत है, क्योंकि तू औरत है, क्योंकि तू औरत है। थैंक यू। थैंक यू। ये नज़्म जिसका टाइटल है तेरी कमी इज़ ए फ्यूजन ऑफ पोइट्री एंड आर्ट, the painting is from the collection of the Ragamala paintings from the Prince of Wales Museum. मेरी नजर में देख लो वही नमी है आज भी, नमी आंखें नम है उनमें आंसू है। मेरी नज़र में देख लो वही नमी है आज भी, नज़र में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, तेरी कमी है आज भी। मेरी नज़र में देख लो वही नमी है आज भी, नज़र में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, तेरी कमी है आज भी। तेरे ख्याल की खुशबुएं जिस्म से लिपट के रह गईं, तेरे ख्याल की खुशबुएं जिस्म से लिपट के रह गईं, हजार लम्हों की खुशी सदियों की उम्र जी गई। तेरे ख्याल की खुशबुएं जिस्म से लिपट के रह गईं, हजार लम्हों की एक खुशी सदियों की उम्र जी गई, जिसे मिटा न सका वही कमी है आज भी, जिसे मिटा न सका वही कमी है आज भी, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, तेरी कमी है आज भी। मेरे इरादों को थामती तू मेरे साथ क्यों नहीं, मेरे इरादों को थामती तू मेरे साथ क्यों नहीं, मुझे दूर से पुकारती तू मेरे साथ क्यों नहीं, मेरे इरादों को थामती तू मेरे साथ क्यों नहीं, मुझे दूर से पुकारती तू मेरे साथ क्यों नहीं, पूरी न हो सके कभी वही कमी है आज भी, पूरी न हो सके कभी वही कमी है आज भी, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर हैं, तेरी कमी है आज भी। खामोश इस फिजा में बस तेरी ही याद आती है, खामोश इस फिजा में बस तेरी ही याद आती है, सुबह से शाम के लिए जैसे ही रात जागती है, खामोश इस फिजा में बस तेरी ही याद आती है, सुबह से शाम के लिए जैसे ये रात जागती है, जिसे छुपा न सका वही कमी है आज भी, जिसे छुपा न सका वही कमी है आज भी, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर है, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर है, तेरी कमी है आज भी। मेरी नजर में देख लो वही नमी है आज भी, नजर में ख्वाब वहीं पर है, तेरी कमी है आज भी, तेरी कमी है आज भी। थैंक यू, थैंक यू। वी हैव कम टू द कंक्लूडिंग पोएम ऑफ द डे, जो नज़म मैं अभी सुनाने जा रहा हूँ, एक शहज़ादी। बट उससे पहले लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस टू यू मंगला भट्ट, प्लीज़ गिव हर लॉर्ड राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, थैंक यू। वी आर वेरी थैंकफुल टू हैदराबाद लिट फेस्टिवल हु हैज़ एक्सटेंडेड अस दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू परफॉर्म। ये एक दास्तां है, एक स्टोरी है, एक कहानी है एक शहज़ादी की, प्यार में उभरते जज्बातों की, जिसने सब कुछ हार कर भी सब कुछ जीत लिया। Mangala ji and I would be performing the last poem for the day, Ek Shahzadi. शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे इतलाती थी, एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे इतलाती थी, मौसम का लिबास ओढ़े गीतों की डोली में आती थी, मौसम का लिबास ओढ़े गीतों की डोली में आती थी, शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे इतलाती थी। फूल शर्माते थे होंठों को देखकर, धूल किस्मत गुनगुनाती थी, शर्माते थे होंठों को देखकर, धूल किस्मत गुनगुनाती थी, जुल्फ बदलते थे कारवां बादलों के, आंखों से रात शर्माती थी। एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे चलाती थी। बरसात का मौसम जब आया, तो बूंदों का प्यार रुखसार पर हवाएं बातों को दूर दूर तक ले जाती थी। एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे चलाती थी। भीगी हुई जुल्फें लिए पलकों पर अरमा लिए, ये दूर दूर तक अपने निगाहों के तीर चलाती थी। एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे चलाती थी। एक दिन शहजाद जब आया तो आंखों की चमक बढ़ने लगी। वीरां थे ये मौसम और बाग, झील के किनारे वो सोचती थी। अब क्या मौसम ने बदले रंग और निखार आई बूंदों पर, चुपचाप कायनात हो जब इशारों में बातें होती थी, एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे चलाती थी। एक रात चांद के माथे से, अचानक रोशनी कम होने लगी। ऐसी मिसाल दी उसने के जन्नत में आग होती थी, अपने ही होश से अजनबी छोड़ करके जमाने को, सहमी हुई वो आकर के आंसुओं से झील भरती थी। जब देखा ना गया तड़पते खुदा से, तो नाजिल उसकी रहमत हुई। शहजाद के ही कब्र में शहजादी की रूह रहती थी, ता खयामत याद रहेगा ये अफसाना झील का, फिर लोग हमेशा यही कहेंगे मोहब्बत में ताकत कितनी थी, एक शहजादी बावली बनकर झील के किनारे तिलाती थी। मौसम का लिबास ओढ़े गीतों की डोली में आती थी, थैंक यू सो वेरी मच, थैंक यू लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, थैंक यू वेरी मच। डू यू वांट टू
या थैंक यू, इकबाल जी, थैंक यू HLF एंड ऑल सपोर्टिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स, for giving us this opportunity, wonderful opportunity. Thank you, Patni sir, for wonderful poetry. Thank you.